impressions for a number of reasons, and there's a couple different types of impressions that we look at. Today we'll look at a shoe impression. It's taken in mud and cast with, thanks to DePaolo, dental stone, but plaster of Paris is also used for as a casting material. Shoe impressions, hand impressions, tire impressions, any kind of impression that's made in mud, dirt, asphalt, tile floor, can be photographed, recorded, and an impression can be made. So we'll take a look today at using the dental stone and the plaster of Paris as a math project to determine what works best and what the combinations of the plaster of Paris and the dental stone, what the combination is in terms of water and the mixture itself together. Take a look at using plaster of Paris and dental stone for impressions in crime scenes. We're going to take a look at the combination of water with plaster of Paris and water with dental stone and the amounts that are used to come up with an effective mixture so that the impression sets the right way and that you get a good impression once the impression is dug out of the actual mud or wherever it is you happen to be putting the plaster down. Impressions can be taken from any kind of mud, dirt, asphalt, tile. You use a number of different tools for that. You can actually use adhesive plastic for tile floors. And for mud, obviously, we're going to use the plaster of Paris and the dental stone. Today, dental stone is used more than plaster of Paris. It's kind of taken over as a more consistent product for those types of impressions. It's what's used by police out in the field when they actually go out and do the impressions themselves. We have done tire impressions in the past. Today we're going to take a look at a shoe impression of a Gauls tactical boot, and we'll see what kind of impression the mixture comes up with. Today we're going to take a look at comparing samples of boot prints that were taken with dental stone and plaster of Paris. If we zoom in on the samples here and we compare the two samples, we can see why the police actually have gotten away from using plaster of Paris and are using dental stone. You can see that the dental stone sample is just excellent. The quality of the impression is excellent. And actually with the dental stone you can use moisture or water to clean up the impression so that the image quality is just perfect. Here you can see the dental stone, a lot rougher, a lot more raw in terms of the actual impression that was taken. Not as great a detail in between. So you can see in terms of why police organizations in the last 10 years or so have really gotten to use dental stone more and more. Just great stuff to work with. In terms of time and setting up, the dental stone sets up a little faster than the plaster of Paris. Plaster of Paris takes a good bit of time. Also, if your water mixture ratio for plaster of Paris isn't just perfect, it really takes a long time for the plaster to set up. It can stay watery for hours and hours before you'll actually get any sort of a hardened impression. Dental stone, just a little more consistent in terms of how it sets up in time, quicker, and a higher quality setup once the actual cast is made. In terms of price, if you happen to know a dentist, it can save you a lot of money. But if not, the dental stone can be purchased through a factory warehouse or a dental supplier, whereas the plaster of Paris is actually ordered in smaller boxes at places like Lowe's and Home Depot. By ordering the larger boxes of the dental stone, I think you can save some money. The smaller boxes of plaster of Paris can run you $3-4 at Home Depot, so that can add up. I would say you could probably get two impressions out of one box of plaster of Paris. So in terms of price and the amount of samples that you can actually do, I think the dental stone is definitely the better choice of the two.